Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear respected brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, we've now made it to day 7 of the quarterfinals. Alhamdulillah, the first 6 days so far have really been eye-catching, for one, definitely. But we've really unearthed some real raw talent within this ummah, alhamdulillah. You know, these are some young kids who are coming on stage knowing, you know, that not only the contestants and their families are watching them, but hundreds, if not thousands, of people who are watching on TV as well. But these kids are coming on stage and reciting just confidently, so eloquently, with the correct pronunciations. Alhamdulillah, it's really a wonder to see, and it's really a proud feeling, not just I'm sure, you know, for the contestants and their families who come here to support them. But it's very proud for, you know, the organization behind the Q Factor, because, you know, the whole intention, you know, we can see it kind of realizing in front of our eyes as well, alhamdulillah. So jazakallah khair so far for everyone who has taken part, and, you know, for all those who are watching and, you know, have carried on supporting the Q Factor from its very inception. Now today, obviously, alhamdulillah, we've made it to day 7 now. We've got some more very interesting individuals, alhamdulillah, very, I'm sure, very worthy contestants who will be, inshallah, very shortly coming on stage to try and see if they can get through to the semi-finals. Now, as we've been mentioning from the very beginning as well, at the end of the show, we won't be announcing the winners of that of today's show, for example. The contestants who will actually make it through to the semi-finals, the winners will be announced on the very last quarterfinal, inshallah. So you can obviously keep watching, and obviously you'll get the results at the end of the quarterfinals. Alternatively, obviously, you can go onto the website, which is qfactor.org.uk, and obviously the winners will be announced on there as well, alhamdulillah. Now, just for those, I'm sure a lot of you who are watching have been watching from the beginning of the quarterfinals and are fully aware of the rules. But just again, just for those perhaps who are watching this for the very first time, in short, inshallah, each contestant will come on stage and recite 3 minutes from any portion of the Quran that they've chosen. Once they've actually recited the 3 minutes, they will be asked 4 tajweed questions, 2 from each of our judges, inshallah. And then likewise, you know, each contestant will come and recite and answer those questions as well. Now, I'm very honored to have 2 esteemed judges with me, alhamdulillah. So on my immediate left, I have Sheikh Abdullah Al-Mamoun, who is the teacher at Darul Uloom Birmingham. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh. And jazakallah khair for joining us. And on my far left, I have Sheikh Anhar Ahmed, who is the teacher at Darul Latif, Darul Hadith Latifia in London. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Alaykum salam.
Jazakallah khair for once again joining us. Now, Sheikh, Sheikh Anhar, obviously, if I can just start with you. For a lot of these students, it's probably the first time that they've made it this far. You know, it's a different setting, speaking into a telephone and answering, you know, reciting like that. Now it's a bit more of a hot seat now. What sort of advice would you like to give to our contestants today?
Jazakallah. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. MashaAllah, first of all, I would like to say that alhamdulillah, you know, you've managed to come through to the quarterfinals by passing the telephone rounds. And as Brother Asif has mentioned, that it is quite different, because when you are reciting on the phone, you know, you're at your home, at your own comfort, okay, you could recite via looking, but here, you know, you're reciting in front of the judges, alhamdulillah, and, you know, you need to make sure that now we will be, you know, physically looking at the pronunciations, your makharij, your mudud, and so on and so forth. So, bearing in mind that, inshallah, I know you've been practicing for the, you know, past few weeks, and alhamdulillah, today is to, you know, give it your best shot, and inshallah, all goes well. Barakallahu feek.
Jazakallah khair. And Sheikh Abdullah, if you'd like to add anything to that.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, wa la'aqibatul al-muttaqeen, wa salatu wa salam ala rasuli Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'een. First of all, jazakallah khair for this opportunity. Just Sheikh over here has already said pretty much what has to be said. I would just like to add, do the best you can, be confident, and consider yourself fortunate, you know, considering that you are blessed to be here compared to all these other people who may have tried just like you but haven't been able to pass that, you know, previous round. So be confident, give your best shot, and don't be disheartened if today wasn't your day. Try again, and this is one of those things where you keep trying and eventually you reach the next stage. So, inshallah, I hope you all do good, inshallah.
Yeah. Just looking forward to, you know, hearing their recitations. You know, yesterday I wasn't feeling quite well, but I thought, you know what, I'm going to make this sacrifice. Sure. I want to come and hear, you know, their beautiful recitation and some of the recitation from the past weeks. Alhamdulillah, the first week I remember, my brother, he recited Abdullah Norman Al-Madani. His recitation, I still probably hear it every day. Subhanallah, amazing recitation. And
Sheikh,
I'm just looking forward to
it. You will not be disappointed today, trust me.
Inshallah.
We've got definitely some excellent reciters for you today, inshallah. Well, let's crack on, inshallah. Let's bring on our first contestant, inshallah, who is 12-year-old Muhammad Yasin Ali from London. If I can ask Yasin to come to the stage, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu wa rahmatullah. How are you feeling today? You okay?
Yeah.
You're looking good? Yeah? Alhamdulillah. Did you take part last year? And how far did you get last year? Remind me.
To the quarterfinals.
To the quarterfinals. Okay, alhamdulillah. Well, congratulations for getting this far as well. Have you been practicing?
I've been memorizing for half an hour every day.
Okay, mashallah. And do you have a teacher or do you do at home or?
I have a teacher.
You have a teacher as well, yeah? Okay, alhamdulillah. Are you feeling confident about today?
Yeah.
Inshallah, inshallah. Okay, Yasin, when you're ready, you can begin your recitation.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alif lam. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين يخادعون الله والذين آمنوا وما يخدعون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا ولهم عذاب أليم بما كانوا يكذبون وإذا قيل لهم لا تفسدوا في الأرض قالوا إنما نحن مصلحون ألا إنهم هم المفسدون ولكن لا يشعرون صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله beautiful recitation ما شاء الله. How do you feel, Yasin?
Okay.
Feel good?
Yeah.
Yeah? Alhamdulillah. I like the bit, you know, where in between you got stuck and you went back about 3 times, then you got the correct line after, which was very good. Alhamdulillah, it shows you've really practiced and you've done well, alhamdulillah. If I can start with, you ready for your questions?
Yeah.
Yeah? Sheikh Abdullah, your question inshallah.
MashaAllah Yasin, that was very beautiful. First question is, what is happening in min qablik?
It's ikhfa nun sakin. If after nun sakin or tanwin comes, any letter except for ya malun and the photo letter and ba, then you have to make you have to make the hiding sound. You have to make gunna and hide the nun sakin or tanwin into. You have to hide the nun sakin or tanwin for 2 seconds.
Would you define the rule of ikhfa one again?
If after nun sakin or tanwin comes any letter except for ya malun, the 6 letters of ya malun, 6 letters of the 6 photo letters and ba, then you have to hide the sound of nun sakin or tanwin for 2 seconds with a light nasal sound.
Jazakallah khair. That was the second question. The definition of ikhfa.
Oh, that was your second. Okay, inshallah. Okay. And Sheikh Al-Had.
MashaAllah, Yasin, well recited. My two questions are, first of them, بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ. Give me one rule from what I've recited.
There's nun sakin ikhfa as well.
Where did the nun sakin ikhfa take
place? Unzila.
Okay. وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. Okay. Tell me the rule that takes place between عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ, in between these two verbs.
The mim sakin is hashafwi.
Okay, thank you. MashaAllah.
Yeah, jazakallah khair. And Yasin, who have you come with today?
My two aunties and my three cousins.
Oh wow, you've got a big team here today. Alhamdulillah. Can we get, I don't know, one of the aunties or one of the family members? Wa alaikum salam, jazakallah khair for joining us. What did you think? So you're the auntie, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, what did you think of your nephew? So
I think he's reading good. It's better. My brother not coming.
Okay.
My mom is very ill.
Okay, yeah. May
so
Allah
you
give
can
her shifa, inshallah.
Everyone can dua for my mom.
Yeah. May Allah grant her shifa. No, it's done very well.
Yes.
It's always very nerve-wracking to be the first person.
Yeah, we're proud of her.
Yeah. Alhamdulillah. Yeah, no. He's done very, very well. You know, keep supporting him, keep making dua for him as well. And I'm sure he will get very far. No, very, very good start, alhamdulillah. Yasin, jazakallah khair.
As-salamu alaykum.
Alaykum as-salam. MashaAllah, beautiful start to today's program. Let's call upon our second contestant, who is also from London, 10-year-old Tayyiba Uddin. If I can ask Tayyiba to come to the stage.
As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salam. Tayyiba, how are you feeling today?
A bit nervous.
Is it because of them too?
No.
No need to be nervous. Look, he's already smiling.
MashaAllah, we're just human beings as well, yeah. So we're just looking forward to hear.
Alhamdulillah. Have you taken part before? Was it last year?
Yeah.
How did you do?
Quarterfinals.
Okay, MashaAllah. Well, congratulations again for getting this far. Let's see if you can get further this time round. Have you been practicing? You feel like you're ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, inshallah. Okay, Tayyiba, when you're ready, you can begin recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر. سبحان الله عما يشركون. هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Another beautiful recitation. ما شاء الله. You feel better after that? Yeah, because you didn't sound nervous at all when you started reciting, to be honest. So, alhamdulillah, very, very well done. You ready for the questions?
Yeah.
Inshallah. Sheikh Anhar.
MashaAllah. Good recitation, Tayyibah. How do you think you've done?
Okay.
Good. Which recital do you listen to?
Mishari and...
Mishari al-Aflas. MashaAllah. Good. You did well. My question to you.
لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن.
Okay. أنزلنا.
نون ساكن إخفاء.
Okay.
If after نون ساكن, except the 6 vowel letters, the letter ba and any of the 6 jamal letters, if any of the other 15 letters come, then you hide the voice of the noon into your nose for 2 seconds with the light nasal sound.
What are the 15 letters?
Ta, tha, jim. Dal, zal, za, sin, sheen, sod, dot, ta, za, fa, qaf, and kaf.
Good, well done, mashallah. one of the other verses you recited, Huwallahu al-Khaliq. Okay, the letter kha. What's the makhraj of kha?
Read from the top of the throat.
Okay, that's fine.
Jazakallah khair, and Sheikh Abdullah.
من خشية الله. What is happening between the noon sakin?
Noon sakin is har. If after noon sakin, if any of the 6 vowels come, hamza ha, ayn ha, ghain kha, then you read the noon sakin clearly.
And can you give me an example of mad muttasil from what you recited?
Faizun.
Jazakallah khair. They all seem to be very confident today, alhamdulillah.
Mashallah.
And who, Tayyibah, who have you come with today?
My mom, my 3 cousins, and my auntie.
Oh wow, you guys have come really fully prepared today. Okay, let's have Tayyibah's mom then. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah, jazakallah khair. What did you think of Tayyibah?
I'm so proud of her. She read very well.
No, she's done very well. I mean, they're all very young. She's 10 years old,
yeah.
To be honest. So, alhamdulillah, she's very confident.
Mentally, they are not, you know, the prepare the competition because my mom is so ill. So we just ask you, pray for my mom.
Inshallah. May Allah grant her shifa, definitely.
She is the last stage, is now doctor said.
Okay, may Allah grant her.
May Allah grant her shifa.
Shifa, inshallah. No, jazakallah khair. No, jazakallah khair for coming. Atayba, jazakallah khair. Beautiful presentation, mashallah.
Assalamu
alaikum. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Sheikh Anhar, it's getting tough already, yeah?
Yes, yeah, mashallah. One thing we're seeing that all of our reciting, that which was evident in the telephone runs as
yeah.
well, that even though they're here reciting in front of, you know, thousands
they're
of people.
They're still very confident.
You know, not only they are famous, mashallah, famous for reciting the Quran, and they seem very confident,
very
mashallah.
Confident. Mashallah, well done. Yeah. You not know, just with the recitation, but with the questions as
yes,
well.
Yes, of course, mashallah.
Alhamdulillah. Let's see what we've got next in store, inshallah. If I could now call upon 13-year-old Hamidul Islam from London. Hamidul, if you can come to the stage, inshallah.
As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. Hamidul, how are you today?
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, how are you?
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. He's even more confident. He's asking me questions now as well. Alhamdulillah. You got to the final last year, didn't you?
Yes, alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. So this year it's got to be winning it, yeah?
Inshallah.
How are you feeling though? You've been preparing well?
Hopefully, inshallah. Yeah? Done enough.
You feel like you're ready?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Okay, Alhamdulillah, when you're ready, you can start with your recitation, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كافها يا عين صاد ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال رب إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا وإني خفت الموالي من ورائي وكانت امرأتي عاقرا فهب لي من لدنك وليا يرثني ويرث من آل يعقوب واجعله ربي رضيا يا زكريا إنا نبشرك بغلام اسمه يحيى لم نجعل له من قبل سميا قال رب أنى يكون لي غلام وكانت امرأتي عاقرا وقد بلغت من الكبر عتيا قال كذلك قال ربك هو علي هين وقد خلقتك من قبل ولم تك شيئا قال رب اجعل لي آية قال آيتك ألا تكلم الناس 3 ليال سويا فخرج على قومه من المحراب فأوحى إليهم أن سبحوا بكرة وعشيا يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا وحنانا من لدنا وزكاة وكان تقيا وبرا بوالديه ولم يكن جبارا عصيا وسلام عليه يوم ولد ويوم يموت ويوم يبعث حيا صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله جزاك الله خير. I know you've been practicing because that was exactly 3 minutes. So alhamdulillah, excellent. How do you feel?
Good, alhamdulillah.
Yeah, mashallah. You ready for your questions?
Inshallah.
Inshallah, Sheikh Abdullah.
Mashallah, Hamid al-Islam for that delivery. My first question is, kaf. What's happening here?
The rule that is happening here is mad lazim, harfi mukhaffaf. Should I explain it?
Can you define?
Because if you spell out the letter kaf with the Arabic letters, the fa has a sukoon. So you have to make, you stop in it and you have to make 6 counts long.
Can you define the mad lazim?
Mad lazim is... What do you mean by define?
What's the definition of mad lazim?
It's like when you...
What do you understand?
There's 2 types of mad lazim. There's mukhafaf and muthakkal. Mukhafaf is when you stop on a letter, or stop on a mad letter, and it has sukoon on it. Muthakkal is if you stop on a mad letter and it has a... letter with shadda on it.
Jazakallah.
Yeah, Jazakallah. Was that the 2 questions?
That was 2.
Yeah, okay, Sheikh Anhar.
Okay, mashallah, well recited. My 2 questions are, the first question, يا زكريا إنا نبشرك.
Okay. Should I explain the mud?
So I haven't asked my question yet. I just recited the word. So give me one rule from what I've recited.
There's mud munfasil in this ayah because there's a mad letter and there's a hamza at the beginning of the next word. So you have to make this 3 to 5 counts long.
Okay. My second question, milladunk. Okay. So mil. What rule takes place there?
I believe this is idgham without gunna because after the noon sakin, there is a lam. So you have to merge the noon sound and the lam sound without any gunna.
Okay, good, mashallah. Well done. You did very well.
Mashallah, jazakallah khair. And Hamdul, who have you come with today?
My mom and my aunt.
Is that the full team again, yeah?
Yeah.
Are you guys related?
Yeah, cousins.
Ah, you're all cousins? Okay. All right, let's have Hamidul's mother.
Assalamu
alaikum. Wa alaikum wa rahmatullah. Yeah, alhamdulillah, you've done very well. You know, all these kids who have taken part last year, they seem to have improved this year as well.
Mashallah.
So even though he got through to the final, you can still see a jump from last year to this year, alhamdulillah. Achacha, mashallah. How much have you memorized so far?
I think I'm on my sixth juz.
Sixth juz, yeah? Mashallah. Okay, mashallah. May Allah make the rest of it easy for you as well.
Ameen.
Inshallah. Inshallah. Definitely. No, these kids are getting very far. Mashallah. Alhamdulillah. You're doing very, very well.
Keep practicing and just keep practicing. Focus on your tajweed.
Yeah.
Inshallah. Yeah. Jazakallah khair. Hamidul? Jazakallah khair.
Jazakallah
khair. Mashallah, another beautiful recitation there. Now, inshallah, we will be going for a very short break, inshallah. But do stay tuned and join us immediately after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Ya ummati al-Qur'an habl najatina fatamassaki bi'urahu kay la naghraqa.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome back to Alhamdulillah, day 7 of the quarterfinals of Q Factor, season 5, Alhamdulillah. I think just going by the quality of the recitation, Alhamdulillah, we have had so far in the first segment, I'm sure it's going to be an awesome day today. And just before I call upon our next contestant, inshallah, I think it'd be nice to get some just generic feedback from our judges, inshallah. If I can start with Sheikh Abdullah, just generically, I mean, just generally, how have you found everything today?
I'm actually quite impressed by the performance so far. It's apparent that the students who have come here, they've really prepared.
Yeah.
They're very confident, mashallah. So that's very impressive. Very much.
And anything you'd like to maybe advise for the ones who are still to come on?
Well,
I'm
guessing they're quite worried. But, you know, do your best.
Inshallah. And Sheikh Anhar, anything you'd
mashallah,
like to?
Mashallah, just same thing really. Mashallah, they've done very well, alhamdulillah. And clearly shows that, you know, the part from the Quran that they have chosen, they've practiced that quite well.
Yeah.
One piece of advice would be that the part that you have chosen, I would advise if you could go through each and every verse and just making sure what are the possible rules that we can ask.
Yeah.
Okay, the tajweed rules. So inshallah, so you have the best chance to pass, inshallah.
But are you feeling better, Sheikh?
Yes.
Alhamdulillah. Let's see who we have next in store, inshallah. If I can now call upon, also from London, 13-year-old Iftikhar Ahmed.
MashaAllah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. How are you feeling, Iftikhar?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, alhamdulillah. What did you think of the first three that came?
They did good.
Are you related to them as well? Oh man, we've got that entire family in today or something. Yeah? Alhamdulillah. What do you think? They're done okay?
Yeah.
Yeah? Are you feeling... Did you take part last year as well?
Yeah.
How did you do?
I went to the quarterfinals.
Quarterfinals, okay, inshallah. Well, let's see what we can do this time round, inshallah. And how have you been practicing generally?
Every day I've been reading for at least an hour.
Okay.
Going over the rules and that.
Inshallah. Do you feel you're ready, yeah? Inshallah, excellent. Okay, Iftiqar, when you're ready, you can start with your recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام را تلك آيات الكتاب المبين إنا أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا لعلكم تعقلون نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص بما أوحينا إليك هذا القرآن وإن كنت من قبله لمن الغافلين إذ قال يوسف لأبيه يا أبت إني رأيت أحد عشر كوكبا والشمس والقمر رأيتهم لي ساجدين قال يا بني لا تقصص رؤياك على إخوتك فيكيدوا لك كيدا إن الشيطان للإنسان عدو مبين وكذلك يجتبيك ربك ويعلمك من تأويل الأحاديث ويتم نعمته عليك وعلى آل يعقوب كما أتمها على أبويك من قبل إبراهيم وإسحاق إن ربك عليم حكيم صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Another beautiful recitation. What made you pick that surah, Surah Yusuf? What was your reason behind that?
I'm not really sure. I think I just sort of liked reading the surah then.
Okay, mashallah, mashallah. Alhamdulillah. Good enough reason to be honest. Alhamdulillah. You've done well, alhamdulillah. You ready for your questions?
Yeah.
Inshallah. Sheikh Abdullah.
Jazakallah khair, Iftikhar. Bima awhayna, which root is found here?
Bima awhayna is mad munfasih. Because if after a mad letter, if a hamza comes in the next word, when it's mad munfasih, 3 to 5 alif long. And yeah.
And yajtabika.
Yaja is so it's qalqala because qalqala sugra because if any of the 5 qalqala letters come and they have a sukun, you bounce the sound of it and it's sugra because it's in the middle of the verse.
And the letters of qalqala?
Qaf, ta, ba, jim, and dal.
Okay,
mashallah, good recitation. Your first question. Tell me the makhraj of the letter Ayn.
Ayn, it's middle section of the throat.
Okay. And aduwwum mubin. Tell me the rule that is applied here between the two words.
Aduwwum is going to be idgham gunnah because if after nun sakin, if the yamun letters come, then you have to hide the nun sakin into the letter or tanween into the letter, then you have to make gunnah with it.
Is this a nun sakin example or a tanween example?
A tanween example. Yeah, okay. Tanween example.
Final answer?
Yeah.
Okay, good. MashaAllah. Well done.
MashaAllah. Tazakallah khair. So, Iftikhar, who's come with you? I mean, who?
The 3 cousins and my 2 aunties.
2 aunties. You know what? I'm gonna get one of your cousins to recite. Let's get one of the cousins. Let's get Hamidul or. Okay, go on. What did you think?
I think he did good. Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah.
Not exactly me, but okay.
Do you think he's competition for you?
You can tell.
Alhamdulillah. No, alhamdulillah. Done very, you know, you guys have all done very well.
Yeah.
Alhamdulillah. Do you guys all practice together or do you go study at the same place? Or
we did it.
Yeah.
Okay. Alhamdulillah. No, it's good to see. Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah.
And it's good to see at such a young age. You know, they've picked up on the tunes and, you know, it's very nice to see. Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah.
So, iftikhar, jazakallah khair.
As-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. MashaAllah. Let's call upon our next contestant. Who's come all the way from Southampton. It's 9-year-old Muhammad Ishaq Mia.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Just before I start, you're not related to them, are you? No? Okay, alhamdulillah. How are you feeling today?
A little bit nervous.
No, don't be nervous. Is this your first time?
Yes.
Okay, mashallah. So congratulations for getting this far. And how was your trip from Southampton today?
Boring.
Okay. Alhamdulillah. But you feel like you're ready? You're confident today?
Yes.
You practiced? Inshallah. Okay, Muhammad, when you're ready, you can start with your recitation, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Are you not going to start from the start and then do all in one breath? No? Okay. Alhamdulillah. Sheikh Abdul Basit, huh? Ma shaa Allah. Alhamdulillah. Very well done. You ready for the questions?
Yes.
Inshallah. Sheikh Amhar, your questions.
MashaAllah. Ishaq Mia, how do you think you've done?
Good.
Do you feel better now that you've finished?
Yes.
MashaAllah. I can see that you are trying to recite in Mujawad form, although you didn't need to recite in Mujawad form, but regardless, you know, of your age, MashaAllah, you've done quite well. So your first question. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ. Yeah, خَيْرٌ لَكَ. Tell me the rule that takes place between these two words. خَيْرٌ لَكَ.
إِدْغَام without غُنَّة.
Okay, why do you say it's إِدْغَام without غُنَّة?
Because there's a tashdeed on the lam.
Yeah, you're right. So, carry on. There is a tashdeed on the lam, so. That's fine. MashaAllah, you've done well. Shall we move on to the second question?
Yes.
You ready? Good. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ وَأَمَّا. What rule takes place there?
Gunna.
Okay. What type of gunna? You're right, it's gunna. MashaAllah. No problem, MashaAllah. He did well. Very good.
He's answering with a smile, which is lovely.
Yeah, it's good.
Alhamdulillah. Sheikh Abdullah, your question, inshallah.
MashaAllah, Muhammad Ishaq. فَلَا تَقْهَرْ. Can you explain the rule of the letter Ra here?
Is tafkhim. When the... Because the Ra, it has a... That is due to... No.
Don't be nervous. Just, you're fine, you're doing well. Just take your time.
How will it be recited? How will the Ra be recited?
With tafkhim.
Tafkhim. Do you know the reason?
When the Ra... No, I don't know.
Okay, we'll move on. Jazakallah to the next question. Dhalan. Which rule is happening here?
Madd al-lazim.
And what's the definition of Madd al-lazim?
When tashdeed or sukoon is after the mad, you have to make the mad go long for 5 seconds. Five alifs.
Jazakallah.
Yeah, MashaAllah. See, you did all right, Muhammad. No, you're not getting away for that easily. Hold on. He's trying to get away now as well.
You need to get ready for your second recitation now.
Alhamdulillah. Who have you come with today, Muhammad?
My teacher and my brother.
Teacher inshallah. And brother. Who shall we have? Let's have the teacher, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
What did you think of your student?
Alhamdulillah, he's done well. But he's just reciting good. His tajweed is a little bit... He didn't start tajweed yet.
Okay.
He's memorizing his Quran.
He's only 9 years old.
Yeah, he's memorizing Quran, alhamdulillah, make dua for him.
MashaAllah. How much has he memorized so far?
Four Jews,
MashaAllah.
MashaAllah.
May Allah make the rest of it easy as well. And no, alhamdulillah.
Bit nervous because it's first time.
Yeah. No, it's nervous for anyone. However old you are, when you come here and, you know, the entire TV, people are watching, so...
Alhamdulillah, overall he's done good.
Yeah, MashaAllah. Well, keep supporting him, inshallah, and I'm sure...
Yeah, inshallah. His teachers, his parents as well, his brothers as well, supporting him.
JazakAllah khair for coming.
Very well, MashaAllah. You need to go home and tell your friends that, look, I was reciting Quran live on TV. MashaAllah.
No, you've done very well, Muhammad.
You should be proud.
JazakAllah khair.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
MashaAllah, let's move on to our next contestant, inshallah, who is 11-year-old Yasin Abdul Aziz from London. If I can ask Yasin to come to the stage.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Yasin, how are you today?
Alhamdulillah.
Feeling good? Where have you come from today?
London.
From London, which area?
Manor Park,
yeah? Okay, alhamdulillah, so not too far from here. And is this your first time?
Yeah.
First time, yeah? Okay, alhamdulillah. So congratulations for getting this far. How have you been practicing for today?
Daily, in the morning and evening.
Okay. Do you study like with a teacher or?
Teacher.
You have a teacher, yeah? Okay, excellent, alhamdulillah. You ready? Yeah?
Inshallah.
All right, inshallah. Yasin, when you're ready, you can start with your recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس ضرب مثل فاستمعوا له إن الذين تدعون من دون الله لن يخلقوا ذبابا ولو اجتمعوا له وإن يسلبهم الذباب شيئا لا يستنقذوه منه ضعف الطالب والمطلوب ما قدر الله حق قدره إن الله لقوي عزيز الله يصطفي من الملائكة رسلا ومن الناس إن الله سميع بصير يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم وإلى الله ترجع الأمور يا أيها الذين آمنوا اركعوا واسجدوا واعبدوا ربكم وافعلوا الخير لعلكم تفلحون وجاهدوا في الله حق جهاده هو اجتباكم وما جعل عليكم في الدين من حرج ملة أبيكم إبراهيم هو سماكم المسلمين من قبل وفي هذا ليكون الرسول شهيدا عليكم وتكونوا شهداء على الناس فأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة واعتصموا بالله هو مولاكم فنعم المولى ونعم النصير صدق الله العلي العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Beautiful recitation again. Alhamdulillah. Yasin, how do you feel after that?
Good, alhamdulillah.
Yeah, you feel better, yeah? Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. You ready for your questions, yeah?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. If I can start with Sheikh Anhar.
Okay, mashallah, well done. You were confident. Your tune was good as well. Your first question, tell me the makhraj of the letter tha.
The.
Tha.
From the top of your tongue.
Okay, can you be a bit more specific?
The letter tha. Your lip is touching both teeth, okay. The front teeth.
Good. That's much better. Okay, whereabouts of the front two teeth? Side, okay. Back. Whereabouts from the front two teeth?
Front.
Okay. Tell me the letters of tafkhim.
Not sure.
Have you heard of this rule before? Tafkhim.
No.
No? Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, jazakallah khair. Sheikh Abdullah.
First question. Ma qadarullah. What is happening in ma?
Making it long.
Yeah, which rule is it?
المتصل.
Are you sure? Okay, your second question. Can you define mad asli?
Mad asli is then when there's mad munfasil, if there's a waqf at the end of the word, then mad asli.
Okay, jazakallah.
Yeah, jazakallah khair. And Yasin, who have you come with today?
My dad.
Your dad. Let's have Yasin's father.
Assalamu alaikum.
Salam. Wow, you look really young for a dad, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. You need to tell me what kind of cream you're using, to be honest. Alhamdulillah. What did you think of your son's dissertation?
Yeah, very proud of him.
MashaAllah. No, he's done very well. Good, yeah. Alhamdulillah. It's his first time as well.
MashaAllah.
So it takes a lot of effort, it takes quite a lot of guts as well, alhamdulillah. So he's done very well.
You make dua for him. Hopefully
yeah, no, definitely. Fun, yeah. Just keep on supporting him, inshallah.
Yeah.
Like we keep telling all the parents for all the kids as well. It's only through your efforts that these kids are getting this far, to be honest.
Yeah.
So if you keep supporting them, you'll see the fruits of this effort, inshallah. So jazakallah khair for coming.
Alhamdulillah, yeah.
And Yasin, jazakallah khair. MashaAllah, you've done very well. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. MashaAllah. Let's move on straight to our next contestant, inshallah. It's 10-year-old Umar Ansari. If I can ask Umar to come to the stage.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Umar, how are you today?
Alhamdulillah, I'm fine.
Feeling good? Yeah, what did you think of all the contestants so far? Were they good?
I think they're really good.
Yeah, mashallah. And what do you think? Are you confident today?
Bit nervous.
Huh? Bit nervous. But you're smiling. Or do you smile when you're nervous?
that was a very confident walk to the.
That was a very confident walk. Alhamdulillah. No. You're doing. You'll be fine. Alhamdulillah. But you ready to go? Yeah.
Okay.
Inshallah. Okay. خير. Umar, when you're ready, inshallah, you can begin your station.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله خالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم
Mashallah. Beautiful station, mashallah, Umar. You feel good? Feel better after that?
Yeah.
Who are you looking at? You were looking at someone and you were smiling. Who was that?
Basically everyone.
Everyone, okay. Alhamdulillah. Now you've done very well, alhamdulillah. You ready for your question, inshallah?
Inshallah.
Excellent. Inshallah. Sheikh Abdullah.
Mashallah, Umar, that was a very nice performance. My first question is, when will the letter Lam be recited full mouth?
Not really sure about that.
And your second question is, when will the letter Ra be recited empty mouth?
If there's a kasr before it, and if there's a stop after the Ra, then there's a kasr before it, and then it'll be empty mouth.
Jazakallah.
Sheikh Anhar.
MashaAllah, that was a very good recitation. You know, you were calm. I can see that you were making sure that you are trying to recite each and every letter clearly. And so keep up, you know, the hard work. Your first question. La ilaha illahu. Okay. So la ilaha. So la ilaha. What takes place on the lam?
Is mad munfasil because there's a hamza after it and you join it together.
Okay, hamza after what?
The lam.
Okay, and how long is that mad?
About five alifs.
Okay. Can you tell me the makhraj of the letter tha?
Tha is when, like, the tongue touches the teeth, the front part.
Front part of?
Of the teeth.
Okay, that's fine. Can you be a bit more specific, which two teeth?
The front teeth here.
Good, well done. Excellent, well done.
Alhamdulillah. Well done. Umar, who have you come with today?
My mom and my brother.
Mom and your brother. Let's have one of.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Jazakallah khair for joining us. What did you think of our recitation?
Oh, we're just so proud, my husband and I, just to come this far is such an honor, to be honest, because he loves Quran and the passion he has for it is. It's unexplainable. Yeah, just no. We're so proud of him.
He did very well today, mashallah.
Yeah, yeah. No, they've done very well.
My husband's really missing him because he's an Umrah.
No. Alhamdulillah, he's done very well. Yeah. I know his younger brother's coming.
Yeah.
After as well. No, he's done very well, and it's I think one of the whole intention behind a program like this was to create that zeal and love the Quran back into their children, and you can see this. You know, it's quite evident in all the kids that come to the competition how much. Love the having.
Last year he was desperate to get in, but he didn't. And this year he's just been working on it. And alhamdulillah, he made it. So
hard work paid off.
Yes, definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
Alhamdulillah. So keep supporting him, like we keep saying as well, inshallah. And these kids will have a bright future, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. Umar, Jazakallah khair for the presentation, inshallah. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. MashaAllah, that was Umar, 10 year Umar. Ansari. Let's call upon our next contestant, who's actually Umar's younger brother, I believe. It's Uzair Ansari. If I can ask Uzair to come to the stage. Yes. Assalamu alaikum, Uzair.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you today?
I'm okay.
You're okay, yeah? What did you think of your brother's recitation?
It's good.
Is it okay?
Yeah.
You think you're going to do better?
No way.
Huh?
No.
No, you've got to be confident. Say inshallah.
Say inshallah.
Inshallah. Alhamdulillah. You ready to start?
Yeah.
Inshallah. Okay, excellent. Uzair, when you're ready, inshallah, you can begin.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله جزاك الله خير ما شاء الله may Allah bless you Uzair. What do you think? You feel better after that?
Yeah.
Yeah, alhamdulillah. You ready for your questions? This is a bit weird. Not everyone says no, not really. Alhamdulillah. Let's start with the question, Sheikh.
MashaAllah, you did well. You did just as good as your brother, MashaAllah. So, very good. Your first question, can you tell me the makhraj of the letter Dhal?
I'm not sure.
You're not sure? Okay, that's fine.
So, just before you understood the question, right?
Not like really.
The letter Dhal. So how do you recite letter Dhal?
Where do you pronounce it from?
So where do you recite the letter Dhal from? How do you say letter Dhal? Say the letter Dhal.
Dhal.
So what did you do to say that letter?
I use my tongue.
Good, that's fine. You use the tongue.
Alhamdulillah.
Very good, mashallah.
Your second question?
My second question.
I think that's ghunna.
Ghunna. Okay, that's fine. Thank you.
Mashallah, Uzair. Can you give me an example of qalqala from what you recited?
Jidika?
Okay, and an example of ikhfa.
No problem. That's fine, alhamdulillah. Let's have a word with your brother as well, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum. What did you...
Assalamu alaikum. Just, can I say it's amazing, alhamdulillah. Just, we need to brush up on the rules.
Yeah, no. I mean, yeah, of course. And to be honest, the older you get, you always have to keep brushing up.
There's always room for improvement.
There's always room for improvement for everyone.
Nerves overtakes as well, because we've been practicing a lot. So.
Yeah. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
He seems very confident, to be honest. I mean,
definitely.
For what, 9 years old? Yeah, very, very confident, alhamdulillah. It's nice to see them recite with a smile as well.
Yeah.
It does, you know, it does feel good, alhamdulillah. But they've done both of them, alhamdulillah.
With two brothers with one competition, it's been tough.
No, alhamdulillah, they've both done very, very well. Something you should be very proud of, alhamdulillah. So jazakallah khair. How is it? Jazakallah khair. Inshallah, you can take your seat. Alhamdulillah. Sheikh Anhar, how are you finding it so far? Anything you'd like to say to our contestants so far?
No, it's just the quality is, subhanAllah, amazing. You know, regardless of the age, whether they're 8, 9, 10, they are coming up on that stage and, you know, giving it, you know, reciting so well. And I can see from both age groups, it's going to be quite difficult to actually select the winners. Alhamdulillah, this is what Key Factor is about, isn't it? Bringing out the best from
exactly
our
the
younger brothers and sisters, mashallah.
Definitely. Sheikh Abdullah?
Yeah, again, I want to congratulate the parents, really, that you should be very proud of the performance that your child has given here, and continue to support them and encourage them with positive feedback, and that will, you know, build on their confidence and inspire them to do even better.
Inshallah. I'm hoping our contestants and our parents obviously taking all this advice on board. Definitely. Let's move on to our next contestant, inshallah, who's actually the youngest contestant for today. Can I call upon 8-year-old Muhammad Zahirul Islam to the stage, inshallah?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah, Muhammad. How are you?
Good.
Yeah? How are you feeling today?
Confident.
You feeling confident? Alhamdulillah, that's what we like to hear, huh?
Mashallah.
Alhamdulillah. Is this your first time on this competition?
Yes.
Mashallah. Excellent. Alhamdulillah. And you ready to start reciting? Yeah? Go ahead, inshallah, when you're ready.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. عما يتساءلون عن النبأ العظيم الذي هم فيه مختلفون كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون ألم نجعل الأرض مهادا والجبال أوتادا وخلقناكم أزواجا وجعلنا نومكم سباتا وجعلنا الليل لباسا وجعلنا النهار معاشا وبنينا فوقكم سبعا شدادا وجعلنا سراجا وهاجا وأنزلنا من المعصرات ماء ثجاجا لنخرج به حبا ونباتا وجنات ألفافا إن يوم الفصل كان ميقاتا يوم ينفخ في الصور فتعطون أفواجا وفتحت السماء فكانت أبوابا وسيرت الجبال فكانت سرابا إن جهنم كانت مرصادا للطاغين مآبا لابثين فيها أحقابا لا يذوقون فيها بردا ولا شرابا إلا حميما وغساقا جزاء وفاقا إنهم كانوا ليرجون حسابا صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. محمد, how are you feeling after that?
Bit nervous.
No, why are you feeling nervous for? You've done very well, alhamdulillah. You picked a long surah as well.
Yes,
mashallah. Mashallah. Are you doing the hifz or anything like that? No? Okay, mashallah. But you've memorized parts of the Quran already. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. No, look. And you're only 8, yeah? Mashallah. Mashallah. It's lovely to see you. Alhamdulillah. And you ready for your questions? Yeah? Okay. Sheikh Abdullah.
Mashallah. Muhammad, can you tell me where the letter ha is pronounced from?
In the throat, in the middle.
In the middle, correct. And hum fihi, which rule is happening after the meme?
Sure.
Jazakallah.
No problem, inshallah. Sheikh Anhar.
Okay, mashallah. Naja Alil. Naja. What rule is that?
Kalkala.
Kalkala. Okay, good. Your second question. Naumakum Subata. So what rule takes place in between these two words? The first word is Naumakum and the second word is Subata. So what rule takes place in between those two words?
Is her?
Okay, that's fine.
Jazakallah khair. Muhammad, who have you come with today?
My brother and my dad.
Your brother and your dad. Let's have...
Assalamu
alaikum. Salam wa rahmatullah. Jazakallah khair. For joining us, you've done very well. MashaAllah.
Work. I would like to say thanks to him and especially thanks to his teachers. And actually, I would like to say thank you to Global Aid and Channel S from this such a noble things. Then actually our kids, our new generation, next generation can inshallah find the way to the companion of the Quran. Inshallah. And quickly one sentence my son can
comment. Yeah, of course. Of course.
He was good. He was good. He did very well.
Did you take part this year?
Yes, but I wasn't selected.
Next year, inshallah, yeah? Next year I'm going to be here. Next year you're going to be here. Inshallah. Inshallah. Well, jazakallah khair. You know, keep supporting him. Keep supporting all the kids, to be honest. And, you know, they will, you know, London and UK will become the beacon of the Quran one day, inshallah. You know, when people nowadays, when they want to learn the Quran, they go to, like, for example, the Middle East, they go to the Arab countries to learn Quran, but a time is coming, inshallah, where, you know, people will be flocking to the UK to be learning Quran from these young teachers, inshallah.
Inshallah.
So,
inshallah.
You know, jazakallah khair, mashallah. And Muhammad, jazakallah khair, you can take your seat, inshallah. Mashallah, that was 8-year-old Muhammad Zahirul Islam. We've now come to our final contestant for today. So if I can call upon 11-year-old Asma Kamran Riaz to the stage, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
Where have you come from?
I come from Carmarthen in Wales.
In Wales. See, the accent, eh? You've got to admire the accent, alhamdulillah. How did you come today?
No, we came yesterday.
Okay, alhamdulillah. How is it in Wales generally?
It's really good. Nice.
Yeah, okay, alhamdulillah. Is this your first time?
Yeah.
First time, mashallah, excellent. So congratulations for getting this far as well.
Thank you.
And you confident for today? You ready?
I think so.
Inshallah. Okay, Asma, when you're ready, You can begin your recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان ألا تطغوا في الميزان وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان والأرض وضعها للأنام فيها فاكهة والنخل ذات الأكمام والحب ذو العصف والريحان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان وخلق الجن من مارج من نار فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان رب المشرقين ورب المغربين فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يخرج منهما اللؤلؤ والمرجان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان وله الجوار المنشآت في البحر كالأعلام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان صدق الله العظيم
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله another beautiful recitation ما شاء الله you feel good after that? Yeah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. And where are you learning to recite the Quran in Wales? Do you go to like a madrasa or maktab or something?
No, I learn at home.
Oh, at home, mashallah. Okay. And who teaches you?
I teach myself and my brother helps me.
Okay. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Self-taught, huh? Inshallah. Alhamdulillah, excellent. You ready for your questions?
Inshallah.
If I can start with Sheikh Abdullah.
Mashallah, Asma, can you tell me which rule is happening in Ash-Shamsu after the meme?
After the meme, Ash-Shamsu.
Okay, we'll move on to the second question. When will the Ra, the letter Ra, be recited empty mouth?
Sorry, can you
please? When will the letter Ra be recited empty mouth?
When there is when there is a.
Yes. When there is a.
When there is a zair.
Zair.
Can you elaborate? When there is a zair, where? Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem, inshallah. And Sheikhan, how are your questions?
MashaAllah. Asma, all the way from Wales. First of all, well done. You did good. Your first question, what is the makhraj of the letter ha? How do you recite the letter ha?
In the back of your throat.
Sorry?
In your throat.
Can you say it a bit louder?
In the back of your throat.
In the back of your throat. Okay. And your second question. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ آلَاءِ. So what rule takes place on the letter lam?
Ikfa.
Okay, what do we do to the letter lam?
We stretch it.
Stretch it, good. How long do we stretch it for?
For 6 seconds.
Okay, and what name is given to that rule?
Suffering.
Okay, that's fine. You said most of it, so...
Inshallah.
MashaAllah. Well
done. Okay, that's your question done, yeah?
That's fine.
Excellent. Okay. Asma, who have you come with today?
I come with my brother and my mum.
Your brother and your mum. Let's have... okay, let's have Asma's mother.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. Jazakallah khair for joining us.
Yes, thank you so much for Q Factor who gave us the opportunity to participate in this competition. Actually, it's all efforts of Asma's alone because she did all practice all alone too. Because we don't have any proper teacher in our Wales, in our town.
Okay.
We built the mosque around after Swansea, maybe we know the area. We don't have any in North Wales, West Wales, we don't have any mosque.
Okay.
Just now for few, last year we built the mosque of our own efforts, but still we don't have any proper imam or any proper teacher who can teach our children. So we are the parents who are doing our own efforts.
Maybe she will be the first teacher teaching the lady that
hopefully,
in the area,
hopefully. So we are trying to
Yeah, no, alhamdulillah, I'll take all of that into account.
Bring to make the good Muslims for them.
Inshallah. May Allah make it easy for you in that area, inshallah.
Yes.
So, you know, taking
make
all of that in,
for us.
Yeah, definitely. Taking all of that into account, I think she's done extremely well.
Because it's the first time we are participating and we don't know the rules of Tajweed and how we can do.
Yeah.
Because we know she's reading with Tajweed Quran, but we know how we can learn what the questions will ask the judges.
Yeah. Sure.
And no one will guide us, to say.
No,
one will guide us, so I think where our children are lacking. Most of the children I observe who are participating first time, they are lacking about for this guidance.
I
will request for the Q Factor, if you can put some more guidance on your website about for these rules and what are the questions you are asking for the contestants, it will be easier for them to prepare for all these things.
No, that's fine, inshallah. Jazakallah khair for that. Oh, yeah, jazakallah khair. Obviously, with the tajweed questions, it's a vast, you know, there's so many rules there.
Yes,
so obviously, it's, you know, they won't be pinpointing any specific rules for any particular, because it's based on whatever they've recited as well, and we don't know what the children will recite until they come here. So, but jazakallah khair for coming, and may Allah make it easy, obviously, for you in that area as well, inshallah. And Asma, jazakallah khair, beautiful recitation, mashallah. You can take. Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. MashaAllah, that was Asma Riaz all the way from Wales, MashaAllah. We have come to Alhamdulillah, that was the last of the contestants. Let me get some feedback from our judges, inshallah. Sheikh Anhar. Actually, before you start with your feedback, inshallah, let's get some recitation from you, because I know you're itching away, because every time you were trying to ask a question, you had to put that little bit of recitation in there. So let's hear from you, inshallah.
Must have been too. No problem, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين صدق الله العظيم.
Now for your Tajweed questions.
Alhamdulillah. And they'll be marking, right?
They'll be marking you. No, your just generic feedback, inshallah, for your competition today.
Bismillah. Alhamdulillah. Well done to all of you. Congratulations. You did very well. And just one piece of advice, that you've come to the you've come through to the quarterfinals, and that shouldn't be it. Whether you pass or not, you should carry on practicing. I was talking to one of the parents, and he was saying, specifically Zahirul's father, and he was saying that subhanAllah, this past week, the amount of time he's put in to, you know, perfecting his recitation, working on tajweed and in his recitation, he hasn't worked like this for the past 6 months or so, subhanAllah. And this is what, you know, subhanAllah, thanks to Channel S and Q Factor for putting together this amazing, you know, competition. So keep up the good work, and well done, and I hope to see you most of you in the semi-finals, inshallah, if not all.
Inshallah. And any piece of advice for those of you who will be perhaps, you know, going through to the semis?
Okay, so first and foremost, you should all start practicing, whether, you know, you will find out later on whether you've passed or not. So your preparations for the semi-finals should start. And I can see one of the parents was asking, you know, what specific rules to, you know, focus on. We don't normally give specific rules, because if we just gave, you know, 4 to 5 rules, then some of them would just focus on these rules. We want you to, you know, perfect your recitation in all departments. So not only just maharij, not only just mudu. So focusing on gunna, the types of mud. Because if we just give specific mud, then they won't look at the other types of mud. So looking at all the types of mud, gunna, maharij, especially on maharij, yeah, the pronunciation of the letters. Because, you know, if you don't get the pronunciation of the letters correct, that could change the meaning. So focusing on the, especially on maharij.
Inshallah, JazakAllah khair. Sheikh Abdullah, can we get a quick recitation from you as well, inshallah?
I can't follow that.
Go ahead, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يوم تبيض وجوه وتسود وجوه فأما الذين اسودت وجوههم أكفرتم بعد إيمانكم فذوقوا العذاب بما كنتم تكفرون وأما الذين ابيضت وجوههم ففي رحمة الله هم فيها خالدون تلك آيات الله نتلوها عليك بالحق وما الله يريد ظلما للعالمين ولله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإلى الله ترجع الأمور كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله ولو آمن أهل الكتاب لكان خيرا لهم
منهم المؤمنون وأكثرهم الفاسقون لن يضروكم إلا أذى وإن يقاتلوكم يولوكم الأدبار ثم لا ينصرون ضربت عليهم الذلة أينما ثقفوا إلا بحبل من الله وحبل من الناس وباءوا بغضب من الله وضربت عليهم المسكنة ذلك بأنهم كانوا يكفرون بآيات الله ويقتلون الأنبياء بغير حق ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون
ما شاء الله now your advice for our contestants إن شاء الله
Jazakallah khair for the opportunity. First of all, I want to say for to Q Factor, all the performance today were very impressive. There was lots of quality, mashallah. The students portrayed, the performance they gave were way beyond their age. I saw, for example, someone who was 9 years old was really performing like someone who's much more experienced than that. So that was very impressive to say. The support of the parents is, you know, paramount. Keep on that, mashallah, and also for those people who will be going through, I say to this to all my students, whatever you have chosen to recite, take that, your best chance of any question coming will be on that. Try to find a teacher, whether it's in person or whether it's online, and go through word for word, rule by rule with that teacher. That will be your best chance of moving ahead in the competition, inshallah.
Inshallah, inshallah, jazakallah khair for that advice. MashaAllah, I'm hoping our contestants who are here and those who are watching the program are taking all of this advice on board, inshallah. Unfortunately, we have come to the end of today's program, which alhamdulillah, which was not only interesting, but it was very inspiring as well, alhamdulillah. You know, like the shuyukh mentioned, you know, these kids were reciting well above their age, which is very, very pleasing to see. And you know, I remember when I was growing up, the ages that these kids are at the moment, you did well just to recite, but they're putting the tune and everything in there. It's like a complete package now.
Yeah.
They come as a complete package, so it's very, very inspiring and I'm sure it's a proud feeling for everyone involved, whether it's the parents, the children, the families, or everyone behind the Q Factor as well. It's very, very proud to see. Alhamdulillah. And it just shows us that given a platform like the Q Factor, and we unearth raw talent like this. Because if it wasn't for a program like this, when how would we have heard from someone from Southampton or from Wales it just wouldn't have happened. So alhamdulillah, that is the beauty of this. So jazakallah khair for all of our contestants for coming today, for participating really, really well. Alhamdulillah, may Allah bless you your recitation. For those of you, obviously, who are doing the hifz, may Allah allow you to complete the memorization, inshallah, with ease. And again, obviously, the winners will not be announced today. They will be announced at the end of the last quarterfinals. But what we would advise is that all of the contestants start preparing as though they've gone through. So they have maximum time to prepare for the semifinals, inshallah. For more details, obviously, you can log on to the website, which is qfactor.org.uk, inshallah. But until tomorrow, inshallah, do look after yourself, and we'll see you tomorrow, inshallah, same time, same place. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.